earlier this week on Jesse Spec YouTube channel. So as you could see, I installed the engine in the MR2. Now the next step is, once it's in, the question is, does it run? Join me, because today we're gonna find that out. This video, I'm gonna be installing also my brand new Link ECU, and I'm gonna be setting it up, and we're gonna do all the little procedures that you need to do before starting an engine. So without further ado, join me, and let's start this. Welcome back to the warehouse. As you can see, last week we managed to put the engine into the car. I'm just gonna roll a bit of footage of that being done. I also removed the hood to gain some space, and then I used my new forklift to lift the engine up into its position, and then I tied the engine in with its supporting brackets. And as you can see, the engine was put in last week, and of course, once the engine is in, we want to get it started. But before being able to do that, I need to install my new Link plugin ECU. I'm going to skip to the end here, but you can definitely go check the video in the link above here on how to install yourself a plugin Link ECU in the factory box, as I just did. So here you can see the brand new 2022 K20 Link ECU plugin. I put an expansion loom, and I also modified the casing to be able to get hoses and cables out of the back. And now let's go put it in the car. Here you see I pulled the stock K20 engine harness through the engine bay and into the interior of the car. You can see the hole there in the back. And then we're gonna start plugging in everything.
Hey, what are you doing here, bro?
Oh. Nice to work on cars.
Let me see.
Excuse me, Spikey.
So here you see a Toyota plug from the body, basically, that is gonna have to go into the ECU. And then we of course have the Honda plugs that came from the engine harness that are gonna be plugging in here. And then you can see the other body harness from the Toyota, basically, that has to go into this plug. And let's continue plugging these things in. We still have a couple of plugs left that have to go over there on the side, and we have that little relay, and then finally we'll be able to plug everything into the ECU. So here you can see a few more things are plugged in over there in the back. I'm sorry it's a bit messy, but I'm going to be tidying it all up after. And this is what it looks like. Basically, the mixture between the adapter harness and the directly plugging in harness from the engine bay, basically from the motor. And here we have some extra plugs for some extra sensors, and of course the USB plug that we're going to be using with the computer to get into it. There's also an extra ground wire that we have here. I don't know yet if I'll be using it, but anyway, for getting the engine started, this should be enough. There's also a little relay. So in the end, this is what it looks like. So you see the engine harness is more than long enough to go into the car there. And I've had comments of people saying that it won't fit, but in the end, it actually did. So watch out, the internet isn't always correct. So the next wiring modification you have to do here is look for in the relay box ignition 2 relay that you can see here, the second one from the left. There's a white and black cable coming out of there. This one, basically, we're gonna have to cut it and then splice it into this black and yellow cable. The key element is to make sure you take the relay side and plug it into the black and yellow cable, not from the other side. And watch out, this is not an operation to be taken lightly, so make sure to really make the effort to do this correctly and don't rush yourself and check it 3 or 4 times. So I thought I'd solder it instead of crimping something, so at least it will hold nicely for a long time. And always make sure to check your welds or your soldering welds basically, and do a little tug test also, pull on it. I've done that, and now I'm wrapping it up with the black tape just to make sure we don't have anything. A very interesting find I made for this swap is, believe it or not, the stock fuel hose from the 1ZZ Toyota chassis is a plug-and-play hose that goes straight into the K20 rail, believe it or not, and it doesn't even leak. I could hardly believe it. Here you can see I added some grounding, and I also put the plus cable from the battery into the fuse box, and I've moved two of my ground cables, the purple one and the black one, and now we can put the oil in. And once we hook up the battery, we should be able to start doing some electric checks. The little black thing I put in there is an anti-friction substitute, basically, that you can add to your oil. And it will really do a little anti-friction treatment to all the internal parts of the engine. I thought it's a good idea, since I had a few of them laying around, to add it, and just for the first start, at least, to do that. So I've put way more oil than I do usually, thanks to the Moroso oil pan. I think I put at least a liter more, if not more. And so let's put the both electric cables. Note that the plus plug is actually from the Honda charge harness from the EP3, and the negative one is from the MR2 chassis. And fingers crossed, not everything goes up in flames and smoke. So it seems like things are actually connecting and nothing has burned to begin with. Now let's tighten both electrical sides and...
Yeah, let's turn on the key.
I like that sound. That seems like everything's okay. As you can see here, everything's hooked up. I just extended this plus cable to the Toyota chassis one as well. And now let's check on an electrical perspective if everything seems to work. We have a couple of sensors and lights going on. I didn't bother with that yet too much, but it seems like that nothing has fried yet, which I'm very happy about. So now let's try entering into the ECU and see if things work. All right, so I managed to get into the ECU. I'm quickly going to go through the process of generating my access code that only link dealers can do when you buy the ECU from them. So I copy pasted the code, and as you can see, now I'm in the ECU connected. Don't worry, we're not starting the engine just yet. Since the engine has been turning around and on the engine stand and everything, I think it's really important to actually let the oil pressure generate itself. So I cut the injection through the link ECU, and I'm just letting it turn over and build oil pressure like this. Checking for oil leaks immediately like this, I'm sure that there's no problem or any other issues, and let's try starting it really soon. Before to be able to start it, you have to reactivate the injection system, of course, and I'm going through the basic setup of the ECU, such as defining what sensors are installed, throttle body initialization, trigger initialization, etc., etc. So now we can start giving it a test. Almost got there, looking good. You can tell the car wants to start, but for some reason it dies back down immediately. Maybe there's not enough fuel pressure. Let's give it another try and build up some fuel pressure. Okay, let's take a look at the ECU and see if we have any error codes. For the moment, there are three. First one is The air temp sensor seems to be showing something totally off, and I realized that I hadn't selected the built-in Honda one, so I did that. And then after that, I also saw my map pressure sensor wasn't showing up the right values. It seems like that I had to flip over to the stock one rather than using the built-in one just to get started. Let's try again. Just to make sure nothing's wrong, let's check quickly for oil leaks and if mechanically anything is already damaged. I can't run it longer because there's no coolant in the car yet.
No leaks, we're all good.
Yes, this is the happy face of my engine, my K20 that I've been pretty nervous on doing, to be honest, but this is a huge milestone actually in this project because getting the engine to run in the car is something that is really super important, and I wanted to just touch upon a couple of points. As you could see, I just basically put the engine in, didn't hook up any water hoses, throttle cables, none of that, just the bare minimum just to see if the engine started. So as you could see, I did the link ECU install, I did the wiring part and added oil, and basically that was it. As soon as I saw that electrically things seemed to work, I could connect with my computer to the ECU as well, do all the basic setups such as throttle setup, trigger setup, etc., etc. I could actually start the engine really easily. And why did I do it like this? It's because if there was anything wrong, like even my cam gear timing was off or anything, the chances that I had to pull the engine back out were really high. So I thought, let's just do the bare minimum, just plug things in and do the settings on the computer and just add oil and see, first of all, if mechanically the engine is still working. Still working, yes, because it used to work. That's the good thing when you take an engine apart before, is if it was running before, you're already on a good track. But the other thing is, there's the whole electrics dynamic that is really important and complex, because basically I'm starting with one could consider empty plug-in ECU for a Honda in a Toyota chassis with an adapter harness and some wiring modifications and everything. So there are plenty of places where you can go wrong. So that was my mindset, is to, through this short procedure, basically get the engine up and running mechanically. As you can see, it ran perfectly. I did not tune the car at all yet. It's just a startup map with a few slight adjustments. And electrically, if the engine started electrically, things were working as well. And as you could see, I could already, thanks to that, see if I have any oil leaks showing up. And you could see that there was absolutely nothing. I didn't have one drop of oil. So that means that I can sort of bolt the engine in a definitive way into the chassis now. And the next steps will be basically cleaning up the wiring and the installation, putting the oils, the cooling fluids, and all these other things in the next video, so I can actually put the car. The objective of the next video is basically to put the car back on its wheels and let it drive out of the garage. So I hope I can get that done in 1 week as well. Just so you know, my videos usually are not filmed in advance. So if I tell you it's next week, it's usually next week or maybe 1 week after, but I don't have any backlogged footage. It's really, I film as I go. So if you love this kind of content, if you like this video, I would highly appreciate that you give it a like, that you comment as well. If you have questions, make sure to shoot me comments. As you can see, I really take the time to answer every single one of them, as long as they are within reason, of course. And a sub would be greatly appreciated, because I am convinced also that these videos bring a lot of value and hopefully joy as well to all of you guys watching. So make sure to hit the subscribe button as well. That would be greatly appreciated. And without further ado, I'm gonna tell you, see you next week, and let's hopefully get the MR2 rolling out of the garage. Peace.